Hello friends, let us understand the experiment transfer characteristics of NMOS, that is the IDVG characteristics, and this NMOS is the enhancement type NMOS. So these characteristics we will learn understand today, enhancement type. And this is the diagram shown with a MOSFET image, and this is the circuit diagram. Okay. So here you can find that drain is connected. Since it is a IDVG characteristics, actually we are expecting the IDVG characteristics to be like this. At the end of this experiment, you will expect the IDVG characteristics in this fashion. Okay. So y axis is the ID and x axis is the VGS, and you will be getting in a linear plot for specific value of maybe VDS is equal to suppose 1 volt. You are getting this characteristics. Now let us look at the connections. The drain is here connected to the positive supply, and battery negative terminal is connected to the ground. Here the gate is connected to the positive of the battery, and negative of the battery is connected to the ground. Source is also grounded, and in the NMOS we are also bulk or the substrate is also grounded here. Okay, and the same configuration or the same diagram can be represented in this fashion. So here you can find that this is the symbol of NMOS. So this is the drain terminal, this is the gate terminal, this is the substrate, this is the source, and this bulk is the substrate. So I have given the terms as a 2 1, I mean these are the designations of the nodes. So this is the 2, this is 1, and this is the 0, meaning that D is having 2, gate is having 1, and 0 is designated to the source and bulk as well. And this battery is connected, which is a variable battery, between the gate and source, and positive is connected to the gate, and again the variable battery is connected to the, or power supply is connected to the drain, between drain and source. Okay, so now let us understand how to write the code. So I am writing here, maybe I can use the text format. So let us write this code. So I'll make a slightly increase the font. So basically in the ngSpice, what we are doing in the ngSpice, we are so this is ngSpice coding, and what we are in the ngSpice, I have already told you that basically what we are doing, we are actually writing the comment first. So in the comment, we are supposed to write the title of the experiment. So IDVG characteristics, in short you can write IDVG characteristics of NMOS enhancement type transistor or MOSFET, enhancement type MOSFET. Okay, then the next line I am writing again the comment, because in the comment you will understand what is to be, what is in the next line. So potential, define potentials I can write, so that voltages we can define. So define potentials. So the standard way of defining the potential is, first you are writing the word V, and then which between two terminals, gate and source, that is the our benefit, we are writing the VGS. So VGS is connected between which nodes? Now it is connected between 1 and 0. So I am writing the node 1, then space, and then 0. And then since we are doing the DC, this is a DC source. So in the beginning we are defining the value as a 0. Then we are defining the VDS, and that is between the 2 and 0. So this is between 2 and 0. And again it is a DC source, and I am defining it as a 0. Okay. Now define the MOSFET. Now define the MOSFET terminals. MOSFET terminals. So I am writing that as a comment for your understanding. It is for the first program, I will write the comment. And now we will define, as you all know, the first we are writing the, that also I will write in the comment to understand you. So first letter is the M. Second, you can write anything. I mean, I am writing here my first MOSFET as is M1. So first we are defining the drain, then we are defining the gate, then source, and then substrate. Okay. And thereafter we are writing the name of the device, so name of the MOSFET, and then you are defining the length, and then you are defining the width also. So that is the syntax or the format we are using. And now I will write the actual, we'll define the MOSFET. So drain is connected to 2, gate is connected to 1, and substrate is 0, and source is also 0. Okay, and this is the my device is the name that I have given, and my length is equal to 100 micrometer. Supposing I take length there, and for micrometer you write only U, and W is equal to I am writing suppose maybe 25 micrometer, maybe 25 micrometer. Okay, so this is a quite a large length, or you can reduce this length, maybe 10 micrometer and maybe 2 micrometer I can take. Okay, so or maybe 1 micrometer and 0.25, that also will be fine. Okay, so that is how we have defined the MOSFET. And then next we are defining the dot model. So you are defining the now which model you are using, which capacitance, which MOSFET you are using. So dot model, and the same name you are supposed to give, whatever you have given there. So my device, and this is the NMOS that we are using. So NMOS I am writing there. And now the most important thing is, since we are looking for the IDVG characteristics, we are looking for the IDVG characteristics. So we are actually varying here the VGS, and then we are observing the values of the ID, but for a specific value of a VDS. So dot DC, okay, then VGS I am varying. Okay, what we I am varying? I am varying the VGS. That is, supposing I am varying it from the 0 to 5 in steps of 0.1. So this is the in what steps, that means how fine resolution you would like to have for this plot. The number of points for the plots are more, the more accuracy in the plot, or maybe visualization would be better. So that is I have defined there, 0 to 5, and incremental steps are 0.1. And then VDS I have given that as a specific value. So that is suppose 1 volt. Okay, so what it will do, for VDS is equal to 1 volt, the VGS only one plot we will be getting. Okay, and then in order to avoid the background, so we are writing, I mean black background, to avoid the heavy printing of a black color, we are actually putting this routine dot control, then set color 0 is equal to white, and then we are writing set color 1 is equal to black. Set color 1 is equal to black. Thereafter, width of a line in a plot, that also we can define. Set x brush, this is in the first experiment I am explaining you, brush width is equal to 2. Okay, and then end of this routine, so dot end c, and then end of the program, that is the dot end, END. Okay, so what we will do now, I'll now this is the I hope you have understood everything. So what we have learnt is the circuit diagram, then the program, and then the these characteristics we are expecting. So I will copy this program maybe in a notepad, and then I'll show you how I can execute this program. So let us go to the ngSpice tool now. So I am opening the ngSpice. Okay, and now let us open a blank notepad file. So supposing I open this file in NMOS EIDVG, and here what I'll do, I'll write this program, the earlier program I'll remove, and I'll write copy the one which I have done. So a rest of the things we can put it in the, so this is the program that we have done. So let us save this program as a some other name. Maybe we'll give the test as a program name. So save as, and then we'll delete the upper one. in that trial, you have to give the file name as a trial.cir. Okay, so trial.cir. Now I am removing everything up, whatever I have written, and let the comment be there. So this comment is there. Okay, so I am saving this program, and now I am opening the ngSpice. So this ngSpice is open. Now here I have already told you the now you can see here the first command for source means you are providing the file. So that is our trial is the file, trial.cir, and since it is in the same folder where the ngSpice is there, application software, and these two files are there, this file and the other file, this vcom100.dll. So then you need not give the path of a file because it is in the same folder. My trial file is in the same folder wherein my ngSpice and all other supporting files are there. So I need not have another folder. If another folder is there, then you will have to define here the path of that folder. I mean, you go to that file and there is a, under the properties, you just, supposing it is in the other file. So you just go to the properties, and in the properties you will find the path of a file. Okay, now this is the path of a file. So you will have to write the path of a file, and you just copy paste that path there, and then you can execute the your program. So since now it is in the same directory, I am not giving the path. Okay, so there is an error. Now what is the error? Let us find out what the error is. So there may be the unknown parameter u. So let us find out what can be done for such an error. So this is the, maybe I will write the capital U, and here also I will write the capital U, and let us see whether we can execute this program now. Okay, so I am again putting the source. Okay, now that worked very well. Okay, set no such command, set color 1. So let us that also understand, set color, okay, that space has to be there. So I have now taken the space, and now you can see whether program works fine now without any errors or not. Yeah, and now it is fine. So now run the program, and after running the program you display for getting the node information, and seems there is some problem in displaying that, but let us work out plot for plotting the characteristics -i vds, and fine, we are getting a very nice plot like this. Okay, now so this is the VGS versus the ID, and this is for the VDS value of 1 volt. So what I'll do now, I'll in the program I'll make the changes. I want to it for the such a 3 plots, so I'll be taking it from 0 to suppose 2 in the steps of 0.5, suppose, or in the steps of 0.5. So I'll be getting 4 plots. So let us save that, and let us increase this set brush width to 5, so to get the dark lines, and let us save it. And now you actually run the program. So after running the program, you run this program, and again you do the plot. Okay, so you are getting this plot. I mean, you are getting the 5 characteristics right from 0 to 2 with a difference of 0.5. And as a, now this is the how you are getting the ID VG characteristics. I hope you have understood the program, and you are getting the characteristics like this. So thank you. In the next class we will see the second experiment, how to get a log ID of this plot. Thank you.